My people, it's about that time. Live from the USA, helping you get paid every day. This is the boss of Bitcoin, the Cristo of crypto. It's your boy BK. And if you don't like me, you must not like money. Thank you for joining me, everybody. Today, we are looking at a live market update for BTC to the USD. Gonna show you how to freestyle on Fibonacci using the boss method. But most importantly, we're going to show you how you can profit from the greatest transformation of wealth in the history of humanity. That's right. You heard it here first. If this is your first time tuning in, congratulations, baby. You are now rocking with the best. My name is BK, also known as the Crypto Trader, and I'm the boss of these charts, as you will soon find out. Every day I grace this microphone with my voice is another day you get to profit as a result. So if you haven't done it already, hit that thumbs up, subscribe, turn your notifications on. This is one of the best crypto trading channels out there. And I invite you to join me on my journey to change the world one video at a time. So let's go ahead and make this money. Real quick, before we jump into it, if you didn't see the last video, I suggest you go watch it. This was a thorough technical analysis on BTC to the USD, to where I showed you that we were in the net negative, the long money, the long and strong M2 money had left the market quite some time ago, and we were expecting a fall. I think Bitcoin at the time was around 19.8. Today, it is right around 19, but it actually hit south of 18.5. So, you know, we are indeed falling. And in this video, I hope to give you a little bit more insight on the direction of the market and where we can expect to land after this. So here we are. This is Bitcoin to the dollar, BTC to the USD on a 343, one of our long-term moving average candles. If you look at this chart right here, one of the things we want to note is that there are a few sections of this chart that really come together to make the rest of the chart possible. I think that's a very prominent section. And then even going back, way back, that section right there, between the two of those, you got most of the energy in this chart that you need to make everything else possible. Don't believe me? Just watch, right? Right here's your first Fibonacci. This basically shows you in this first little blue section. We'll delete this one for everybody. In this first section right here, breakout to breakdown, you had enough energy to give you a capstone and start your new cycle right there. This is essentially the end of one cycle and the beginning of another. Remember that number, 30, just call it 32,000, right? Net 30. 30K is basically all of the energy that was transcribed between Bitcoin 5,000 and Bitcoin 10,000. Normally you get about 3.5x on any given run. 32,000 did not disappoint us one bit, right? Next thing you can do is just extend this Fibonacci one more rung to right there, right? Now you have a much, much bigger cycle. And oh, look, by the way, that 32,000 still hold. In fact, it confirms a little bit north of where it projected earlier, but that's still 35, 36, 32,000, somewhere in there. That's the middle of the section. This is called fractal harmonics. The end becomes the middle becomes the end, and the beginning starts itself all over again, right? And so now we see that we have what's called resonance in this Fibonacci extension, to where our end became the middle. And guess what? Up here, up top, bam! Capstone between the 4.2 and the 4.6 on top of that Fibonacci bar right there. Boom, boom. And now you're looking at one complete cycle. Again, all I did was show you three different simple intersections on how you can predicate and dictate the energy flowing in and out of any given chart at any given time. This is very powerful insight, something I developed on my own over the course of 3.5 years. It's called the boss method. So if you haven't seen it, if you don't know how to make money on the charts, do yourself a favor, subscribe, and watch these videos. Better yet, you can just type in the Big Brother, how to chart like a boss. I'm going to develop a course, but for now, you can still find a playlist free and accessible to the world, and that will get you well on your way to making some money on your journey, right? And so now, we basically have our coordinate system set up. We know that this is our top, right? We know that this is our middle slash bottom. And now we start to put this thing together. This is another very, very, very important line. This thing sits at 25. Notice it sticks to harmonic numbers, 60, 32, 24. These are different coordinates that Bitcoin is baked into for whatever reason. I remember back in the day, I bought my first Bitcoin like $480. That was like a magic number for Bitcoin. Once it broke past 480, it went to 64. 48, 64, 24. These are harmonic numbers, right? But now that we're below this threshold, Bitcoin is indeed on a decline, right? And if you don't believe me, you could just literally just do a simple top-down analysis. If you take the top of that trend, the top of that trend, we are not above either of one of those points, right? We're almost baked into this little channel going right here, right? And that's down and to the right. That's not a good place to be for BTC, right? And so now let's jump in on some quick energy. We're going to take this off for a second. I gave you the major coordinates, right? We're going to take this thing off and jump in on a 33. On a 33, we start to see a lot more information that we really didn't know existed before. Again, if you wanted to, you could literally just kind of start to tighten these things down to show the different channels that Bitcoin is moving in. And guess what? If it falls, when it falls, where is it going to go? More than likely, it's going to go to that one right there. Either that one, maybe even that one. That's going to be interesting. But I think we'll just stick at the best fit right about there, right? And so if we did one of these guys, right now we are sitting north of the 3.2, which is right there at 19.8 Bitcoin. Actually, we just fell below that. Wow, look at that. All right, so we're actually below that line. We needed to hold that line, but we didn't. So now the next line of best fit is going to be right there at 17.5. Just call it an even 17.5, as low as what? You got 3 points. This might be the oversell if it really hits it. 14.7. And then the last one, the last little node of resonance, hopefully it could flatten out. 16.6, right? And so what this would look like, right now we're on a downtrend. You might see a little pop back up to 19,000, but more than likely that will indeed turn back around negative with all the momentum inertia had going up to hit 17.5. And if we get a continuation, an oversell, a panic, it won't necessarily be a panic because we see it coming. You could overshoot this thing all the way down to 14.5. And this could happen. You know, inside the next couple weeks, this isn't like, oh, it's going to take 2 or 3 months for this pattern to feel like, no, you know what I'm saying? This is going to happen either way between 9.18 and what's that? That's probably like 10.1, I want to say. 10.4, I was a little off, right? Between 9.18 and 10.4 that we see these patterns coming together. This thing says 9.26, so we'll go with that one. We'll just say sometime in September. More than likely, we're going to see Bitcoin sub 16.5, if not all the way down to 14.5, right? And you know, if this pattern continues, you kind of see where these different nodes line up at. You could really just do that again to go as low as $10,000 before October. I remember saying Black October in another video, Red October, the hunt for Red October. I think Bitcoin's going to continue to sell off. I think we're going to start to see a huge market sell-off. Why do I say this? Well, if you look at the puppetry and fuckery going around you, I drive down the street every day and I see all these billboards trying to get the sheeple to participate in the parade and fallacy known as modern-day politics. And I remember seeing a sign one time that said, "You vote, you lose." I can't say that I disagree. So it's an election year. What do they do with elections? They fuck with people's money. You know what I'm saying? The government gotta shut down. Oh, we need another $1 billion. We gotta cure COVID. We ain't cure COVID yet. Give us some more dollars. Put some more shots in people's arms. You know what I'm saying? Claw some more blood clots. Like, we don't even know what's happening when we do it. But guess what? Your government is always spending money that they don't have. Where does that money come from? It comes from everyone that pays taxes and the rest of the economy. Why do I say that? I say that to say this, that this is an election year. Expect something to happen to get your attention, right? If you go back to Hunger Games, just go back and watch the movie. In the first 10 minutes of that movie, they were sitting on that little green hill. And my man said, "What happens if everybody stopped paying attention? Are the odds still forever in your favor?" Right? And so these are questions we need to start asking ourselves. We are dealing with one of the longest standing scripted television shows of all time featuring your favorite politician. Right? And politicians are always broke. They like the church. They don't never got no money, so they need some more. And this is what happens on election years. Like, markets go down, unexpected events transpire, and everybody stuck like Chuck trying to beg their favorite politician for the next bailout. And that's what we can expect if this trend continues. Now, I will say this. I think Bitcoin is pretty much set to retest support at 17.6. Let's see what's on this long-term chart. Let's see if we got any hooks over here that we can start to sink into. And the problem, the big problem, and this chart is getting kind of crazy, but I'll just put something like right there. The big problem is that on that yellow line, we're gonna move that down here and paint that yellow, right? Or we'll just call it red. On this red line, this terminal support, we'll call it, we don't have too much area over here that we can cling on to. You know what I'm saying? Like, normally when you fall, you need to catch on something. In the markets, it's called psychological support and resistance. Basically, wherever you fall to, you go to the other side of the chart and say, okay, how long were we there? How many trades did we have? How many buyers and sellers did we have at that part of the chart at this price for the market to feel confident and comfortable to stay there? And the answer is not much. Once we break 17.5, and that's this big support right here that we're going to come up on, we have about a month to turn it around. If we just zoom in on that one little part of the chart, how long was this trend? This trend was 150 bar, 30 days. Hit the nail on the head. When you know, you know. We got about a month to get our act together and to get Bitcoin north of about 20,000. Otherwise, it's going to be net negative all the way down to, I will say it right now, 12,000. Let's just call it, yeah, it's probably going to hit like, I say 12,000. Like, if we break 15, we're going to 12. Right now, we broke 20, so we're going to 17.5. Once we break 17.5, more than likely, we're going to 12. And if it break 12, chances are it's going to break 10, consolidate right there, right around 6 to 8. And that's when you want to tell your mama to put the mortgage up. You know what I'm saying? Get you some $8,000 Bitcoin, because that's probably one of the best buys in your lifetime, right? So these are words of encouragement. I think now is literally the time to get your house in order. We are upon the precipice of the greatest transformation of wealth in the history of humanity. The boss is back. You know what I'm saying? I'm here to get the word out to the people. If you see Bitcoin under $8,000, tell your mama to sell her second house. You know what I'm saying? And go buy Bitcoin. Don't even tell me you did it. Just do it. You know what I'm saying? And know that your line will be good henceforth, now and forever. Right?
If we look at some of the CJB publications, this was just published, I believe, a couple days ago, right? It's funny how they let you know what to do before you need to do it once in a while. 90% of the times they don't. But sell your Bitcoin now, crypto crash warning issued ahead. And this goes back to one of the quotes they have in investing, where you really need to play ahead of these puppetry publications. And it's called buy the rumor, sell the news, right? Ethereum didn't just decide to upgrade its entire network. Like, this has been discussed over the course of many, many years. Like, it's upgraded many times. And this last upgrade, I think, the peaked out, you know, the media recognition, it actually started, now that I look at this chart, it started in early April 2021. But everybody knew about it basically in August 2021. So if we were going to buy the rumor and sell the news on Ethereum, either April or August is where you would have wanted to do that thing right there. Right? Look at that. That's August right there. And this is April. Do you see the difference in recognition of media attention around the price, right? That was the opportunity to buy on the possibility, inevitability of an Ethereum upgrade. Let's face it, we live in a technologically driven society. Upgrades happen, right? Every time I turn on my phone, it's upgrading itself, right? These networks will continue to upgrade until they have the best possible version of themselves for society to utilize. That's in the best interest of everybody involved. That's what a free and fair economy looks like. It's always continuously improving itself, right? Now is not the time to buy Ethereum hoping that you're going to make some money on the upgrade, right? The time to do that was back in April, you see? That's actually, you know, what, about 100% Bitcoin, 166% Bitcoin over the better course of a year and a half, which is, on average, about the time it takes to upgrade any given network, right? I say all that to say this. These are tools that you can start to use when you look at these articles. Just look at what are they saying. What's the SEO, search engine optimization? What is the keyword? Ethereum upgrade. Well, let's start tagging that word and understanding it when it comes into existence in the human collective. And let's start to profit when that thing happens, right? Ahead of schedule, not behind. We play in front of the eight ball, not behind it. And once we learn how to do that, I think we will all be better off as a result. Just understand that this is the time to get your house in order. Now is not the time to start trading Bitcoin and Ethereum and Litecoin for the first time, thinking you go flip it and beat the market 3-1. I'm not even doing that. I started making videos again because I realized on this next wave, we will have quintuple the amount of money in the market. And I will have quintuple the amount of followers and people trying to learn how to do this. Every day, I work for a company right now. Every day, we're trying to teach people how to install a Bitcoin wallet, how to buy Bitcoin, what is Ethereum, where can you learn more? Like, it's rudimentary communication, right? And these networks are being built out at such an excelling rate that I believe the educational component is not maintaining pace to supplement the inevitability of global adoption, right? And so that is my mission, to reach and teach as many people as possible with the rest of the days of my life. And so if you down with that, I can get down with you. You feel me? My name is BK. I'm the boss of Bitcoin. You can check my website out, bossofbitcoin.com. I'm going to be redoing everything. You go see a new and improved, lean, mean, you know what I'm saying, money-making machine inside the next few months. Right now, I'm just on my lunch break trying to help some people learn how to trade some BTC to the USD. So if you appreciate that, I appreciate you. Hit that thumbs up. Make it do what it do. With that being said, everybody, it's that time of the day. I gotta go back to work. Signing out. Boss. Boy, BK. Hey, they say, listen. They said BK can't go corporate again. I said, you know what? I thought about it for about 3 years. I took a sabbatical, let my hair grow out. Went out to the middle of the desert, walked around for 40 days, 40 nights. Came back with the following perception. Even Superman and Bruce Wayne had to have a day job. You feel me? You know what I'm saying? I might be Bruce Wayne at nighttime, But you know what I'm saying? I still got to clock in from 9 to 5. Now, 5 to 9, that's a different beast. Let it be known. But that being said, everybody, it's that time of the day. Signing out. Boss. Boy BK, no matter where you stay, Brazil to Bay, the California IA, all the way back out through Jer Money. Good night, good morning, and good day. Thank you for your time. Hit that thumbs up button if you appreciate mine. Till we meet again, stay cryptic, y'all. Peace.
Like a boss. Huh.